Now, we discuss how the optimizer, using the operation costs, estimates, and the statistical information, chooses the optimal evaluation plan. To do that, the optimizer needs to first break the complex queries into simpler blocks and focus on optimization of one block at a time. A block is chosen in a way that it does not include nested queries, and it has one select, one from, and at most one where clause. For example, assume we have the query with the inner query select SID from students where the name is Alice, and the outer query that is trying to find tuples with values of the attribute STID equal to the SID returned by the inner query. This query includes a subquery that is expected to produce a scalar value in its output. The inner query, which is select SID from students where name equals Alice, is considered one block. The outer query, only with the equation that includes the check for the attribute to be equal to the value returned by this query, is considered another query block. The query optimizer considers each block separately and chooses a query evaluation plan for each query block. The query blocks can be evaluated separately. Results for them could be saved and used in derivation of the query. The saved results could be discarded after the whole query is finished. For evaluation of a whole query, the optimizer still needs to consider the interaction of evaluation techniques. This is because just picking the cheapest enumeration plan for operations in one block may not yield the best algorithm for the overall query. For example, using hash join for a query might be the best operation algorithm with the lowest cost. But merge join might provide the opportunity to return a sorted output, which may be usable in the outer query to help enhance the overall query performance. Or nested loop join might enumerate a lot of results, but provide the opportunity to pipeline the results to the next operation and remove the need to write intermediate values to disk and read them back. Therefore, it might impose a lower cost overall. For the rest of our discussions, we will focus on optimizing a single query block, which might still have different operations within one block. Then, when learned about the optimization for a single query block, we will briefly mention how do we put together the plans for the nested blocks. We have learned a little bit about it before. Remember that we mentioned there are two main ways to optimization of the query plans, top-down and bottom-up. The bottom-up method starts from the bottom of the RA representation tree and enumerates the plans up. The top-down algorithms take the other way around approach. The bottom-up algorithms are the more natural and the easier to understand ones, so we will focus on them in our discussions. Also, practical query optimizers generally incorporate elements of the two broad approaches in query optimization. First, cost-based optimization through search of all available plans. The number of available plans for a query might be very high, though. Therefore, this is very expensive and may introduce a very high cost to our optimizer. Note that the cost of running a query includes the cost of the operations and is dependent on the size of involved relations, but it also includes the cost of optimization as well. Solutions based on dynamic programming, including Solinger-style optimization, can help reduce that cost. The second class of solutions, whenever possible, consider reducing the size of the search space from all available plans to a subset chosen by heuristics. While many of these solutions may not optimize plans purely based on heuristics, many of them, for example, branch and bound enumeration or hill climbing, may start a search by using heuristics. The branch and bound enumeration begins from a good physical plan for the whole query selected by heuristics. Then it starts the search for plans for each subquery and replaces the current plan if it finds a better plan for the subquery. The operation can stop at any decided point with the plan in hand or continue with searching the domain for better plans. The hill climbing algorithm also may start the search with a heuristically selected physical plan. The algorithm then makes small changes to the plan. For example, replacing one method for executing an operator for another, or redoing joins by using associative or commutative laws to find a nearby plan that has a lower cost. The search is over when no small modification yields a plan of a lower cost.